Are you sharing anything? Can't see anything.
हाँ यस
Let's
सर,
get black please.
ओके नाउ हेलो,
Yeah, now it's visible. Yeah, now it's visible.
ओके 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 इफ पीपल कॉपीड द प्रोग्राम लेट अस मूव टू द फर्स्ट फॉर्म एंड सेकंड फॉर्म. सो श्रीनिवास एंड श्रीनिवास सर एंड मोग इज आस्किंग, सो वी विल डिस्कस दैट. ओके सो बिफोर दैट इवन from my side I have some questions, like when I return first statement the questions what it arises is like, see if you look at the first form label colon statement 1 statement 2 up to n number of statements then go to label. So from the first form what we understand is once we write the statement go to label, we may come across the question like, is it compulsory that the statements which comes under label should be right before go to, because first in the first form we will look at in that way only. So label colon statement 1 to n, after that go to label is there. So before go to we have written one block of statements where it refers to label. So we will get a question like, should we write in this way only. So when we look at the second form so we will come to know, so it is not like that. So first we can write go to label, then we can write the statements which belongs to the label. So this is one form. And here the thing is, if you look at the example, okay, that is where go to statement is there, after that label, then statement is there. So if you look at the program, see if I remove these two things like go to loop, then loop. So program execution starts from main and it executes the line by line, and when it comes to printf, after printf i++ is executed. After i++ if condition, anyways if the condition is true the statement which follows the condition will be executed, if the statement is false the statement which follows the condition is skipped. So here after if condition, because the condition is true, the statement which follows the condition is get ch, that is executed. After that program is ended. So here if I don't write go to also it is correct, that means the output is same. Okay, so why I have written go to here means just to know the second form. That's all. Second form is write go to label. After that, you can write the statements which belongs to label. So when you look at the first form, it is not like that. First, write the group of statements which belongs to label. Then write the go to label. Okay. And when you look at the third form, so go to label, and immediately after the word label, I have not written statements which belongs to label. So I have written some normal statements. So which doesn't belongs to label, okay, and which is not related to go to also. So these statements are executed one by one normally. After that there is a label. So what happens here is, see because of this word go to label, see when you look at the word go to, after that whatever the label is there, that is identifier, program control will move directly to that. Whether you write before you go to or after go to, program control will move directly to that block. So when it moves, okay, so program control will move to the statements where it belongs to label when the go to statement is executed. Okay, so you look at the third form, after go to label I have written some statements. Those statements are skipped because I am telling go to label. So where is label? After, see here dot dot indicates like four statements. After these four statements label is there. So program control will directly move to the statements where label is there. So these statements are executed once. See, in this case, these statements are executed only once. Again, it will not come to the go to label. So the difference between second, third, and first one is, in case of second form and third form, the statements which belongs to the label identifier are not executed more than once. Only once those statements are executed. Whereas in the case of first form, the statements which belongs to the label are executed many times because of the label. I have written go to label, and the statements which belongs to label are written before go to label. So these statements are executed many times, and intentionally we have to stop that loop, because if I don't write any condition, this will become infinite looping. That means executes infinite number of times. So to stop that, intentionally we have written right if statement. So in the second case, if we don't write if statement also, it will work, because the program statements which belongs to label will be executed once. In the third case also, if we don't write if statement also, it will work, because the statements which belongs to label are executed once, because we have written after go to label. And immediately after go to label, whatever the statements are there, those statements are skipped, because when I say go to label, the program control will directly move to the label block. Okay, this one. Okay, so apart from this, if you have any doubt, you can ask Srinivas sir and Amog.
Okay, what I understand here is in the first one, it is for if condition, this go to label will be working, and if you have to have multiple iterations, maybe say identifying few numbers or extracting names or fetching some results.
Okay.
But in the second one, I think so, going to directly, you know, the first one go to label should be associated with some other, program, part of the program. This can be only a part of the program, because if say we are giving some condition prior to it, say, okay, if this is true, go to this. If this is false, go to the next statement. So in such case, I think probably this will be working.
Yes. It depends on the application, how we need it.
Yeah, it's like if the condition is true,
go to label.
It should go to some other statement.
Yes.
If else, go to this label of statement 1, 2.
Yes.
It could be similar to that, I believe.
Yes. Okay.
Because the first one says it's only all the time it's true, it will just start looping in, and only when it is false will come out.
Yes.
But here, in this, it will be the second and third form is little bit for a complex program, I think, which way we can use, where we want to bifurcate. Say, suppose I'm trying to, just my understanding, if that's an even or odd number, then if I say I is equal to 2 is even, then it will go to some other statement.
Okay.
Go to. Else go to label. So if it's false, it's something of that sort could be of useful here.
Yes.
And not for generation. If you want to actually bifurcate two things, distinguish, like a pass and a fail, or it could be bifurcating the genders, number of girl students versus number of boy students.
Yes.
Like that. Just example some. And that way I'm. Yes, sir. Second and third.
Yes, 100%. You see here. Yes, sir, correct. In the syntax, we should not mention if conditions. Only how we write go to label and label, the statements belongs to label. Only those things we write. Depending on the application, we can write the conditions.
Okay.
Even in case of break.
But we can still write the statement right before the go to label here, it could be that we have in the first instance the label starts first with the statements and go to here as well. Now before the go to label, we can write the if statement.
In the example we can write, sir, but not in the syntax.
Okay.
But in the third case, if you observe, after go to label, some statements are there. Those statements are skipped.
I got it. In the second one, what I'm thinking is we can still give the condition prior to that. If statements definitely comes there, we are pre-checking. It'll be just like the do while loop in the first. The second one will be while do loop. While loop.
Like that, we can understand. Yes.
Like that. So here, if I is equal to even number, then go to label. If I is odd number, then skip and go to get.
Yes.
But in the third one, I'm just trying to understand what kind of statement it could be. Okay, even here we can write that way.
Yes. Actually, okay. So actually, all the authors, I think so, they will give only first form. Just I got an idea how we can use go to statements in different ways. So I have written second and third form.
Okay.
So only first form will be written in all the textbooks.
Okay. Yeah, maybe mostly it feels like logical, you know, the first one. Okay. Go to. But in the second and third, it looks only a part of the whole program where we are just choosing the go to label.
Yes.
And not the entire program or the syntax that we are trying to use. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. So we shall move to the third example. Okay, so third form I have written. Just you can observe the difference between the outputs so that you can understand the way I have used go to in different ways. Here, if you look at the program, say I have written go to label, then after label, immediately I have not written the statements belongs to label. That means printf statement and i++, I have not made it to belong to label. Okay, so separate it is. So one time these statements are executed. Next, I have written label if I less than or equals to n. So what happens here is, see, immediately after the statement go to label, when it comes to the, see here I have used label itself because the word is an identifier, you can use it. Okay, just you have to follow the identifier rules. So this word label follows all the identifier rules. We can use directly as label here. So you just look at the statement go to label. Immediately when program control executes this statement, the program control should come to the statement where label is there. So where it is there? After two statements. The two statements are printf and i++. Because printf and i++ will not execute, nothing is printed on the output. You will just look at the output here. Enter the value of n. Taken value 10. And after that, printf statement is not executed. So nothing is printed. Whereas in the previous case, printf statement is executed once, so it has printed 1. In the third form, printf statement is not executed, so nothing will be displayed. So first value, even first value is also not displayed. Because immediately after this go to statement, the program control should come to the statement where label is there. So where it is there? After these two statements, after printf and i++. So those two statements are not executed. Directly it will come to the label. Okay. So in the label, what it is there? If I less than or equals to n, get ch. Yes, 1 less than or equals to 10. So the program control will move further, get ch, and it will execute the program. So in third form, what we can understand is, after the go to statement, the statements which are present are skipped because after the keyword go to, I have written label. The program control should go to that particular statement, skipping these two statements. Okay. So you can write this program. So or else you can write the part of the program, because everything remaining thing in the program, it is similar to first and second form. So you can just copy from go to label to get ch. Okay. Then you can write this output.
Excuse me, sir.
Ah, yes. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, actually, I wanted you to explain this go to label statement, sir, because once we reach the, you know, while tracing, once we reach the label point, I would feel that if the label condition falls, then where would the control shift to?
Okay. So it will not execute GCX function. It will move to the closing branch of the program.
It means the go to label would only be executed once if the label gets failed.
Yes, yes. Even if in true case also it will execute once, in false case also it will execute once. So only if we consider first form, at least we can get some application out of first form.
Okay, sir. Yes.
Yeah, and one more thing, actually, according to all authors or what we can say in all textbooks, one form they have given. See, again, I will tell you, I think I have told before only, just for us to understand how go to statement can be used in different ways, I have mentioned here another two forms. Okay, so in this way, depending on the logic and idea of our own, we can write many forms. In case of nested if also, I have written many forms. Generally one or two forms they will give, depending on our logic or idea how we can understand. So we can write many forms, because if you write big projects and all, we don't know how, in which form we may use, depending on the applications. So we may getting different ideas and getting different logical things, so we can write in that way. Okay, so we will move to the break keyword. Okay, that comes under jump or unconditional statement. So you can take down the topic name as break keyword,
your
or you can call it as yes sir.
Break.
Voice is breaking, sir.
Yeah, your voice is breaking.
Oh, 1 minute. Okay, so now I think if people can listen. Okay, let me speak. So you take the topic name, break keyword, or it is also called as a statement. So this comes under jump or unconditional branching statements. So we have four statements like go to, break, continue, and return. So here we see about break, go to, break, and continue. When it comes to return statement, we will look into the functions chapter. So there we will come to know the concept of return statement. So when it comes to break keyword, the break is a keyword used to terminate the selection statement. So here selection statement means we have five things: if, if else, nested if, else, ladder, switch. But in, only in switch statement we use break keyword. Okay. So selection statement such as switch or looping statement. So looping statements means you can use in anything like while loop, do while loop, and for loop. Okay. Whenever the keyword break is reached, the program control comes out of the selection statement or looping statement. So again, in the last sentence, if you consider selection statement, you have to consider switch statement, because in switch statement we have used break. Okay. And when you consider looping statements, so you can consider anything like while, do while, or for. Okay. So the concept of break is how program termination happens. That is only part of the program, not full program, because full program is not terminated, only part of the program. That is, it will either terminate the selection statement such as switch, or it will terminate the looping statement such as while, do while, or for. Okay, whenever the break keyword is encountered or reached. Okay, so you just look at this format. So how we can use break keyword in while loop in different ways. Okay. Okay, so I have taken break keyword with example to while loop. It works similar to do while loop and for loop. Okay, so you just look at these forms. So while in first case, if I write the break keyword at the beginning of the loop, that is very first statement after the condition, then what happens when program control comes inside the while loop? Because of the break keyword, the program control will come out of the loop. That is the functionality of break. So it has to terminate the looping statement in whichever loop it is there, while loop, do while loop, or for loop. That loop it should terminate. That is the concept of break. So when it terminates the looping statement, the program control will come at the end of the looping, that is closing brace. So when the program control comes to the end of the looping statement, the statements present after the break keyword are not executed. So I have written here statements not executed, where so in case of break keyword, when we write at the beginning of the loop. Okay, when you come to the second form, okay, so here, so initially we write some statements in the middle of the while loop if I write break. Okay, so the statements which are present before the break are executed normally. So I have written statements executed. Okay, so when program control reaches the break statement, break keyword, what happens after the break keyword? Whatever the statements are there, those statements are not executed when break is executed. Okay, so if break statement is not executed, then these statements are executed. If break statement is executed, the statements present after the break statements or break statement are not executed. Okay, so here we can we'll get a question like, when we write break, it will execute, right? So it is not a rule that it should execute, because it also depends on the condition. In case of go to, we have written if I less than or equals to n, then go to label. So otherwise it will not go to label, like that here also. Before break keyword, if I write the condition, so execution of this break keyword depends on the condition. Okay, so what I have written here, statements not executed when break is executed. So in the other way, if you write statements are executed when break is not executed, so like it we can understand. So once again I will tell you, statements are not executed when break is executed, or statements are executed when break is not executed. Okay, so if break statement is executed, you look at the arrow mark where I have written program control will come to the end of the loop, so skipping the statements present in this loop. Okay, this is the second form. Next, when comes to third form, if I write the break keyword at the last step, at the last, as the last statement of the loop, what happens before the break keyword, whatever the statements are present, those statements are executed normally. When it comes to the break, so program control will terminate this loop. That means the program control will not move back to the condition. See, according to the looping concept, what it is, each time the program control should go to the condition, it has to check the condition. If the condition is true, again the statements which are present inside the loop should execute. That is the functionality of while loop, do while loop and for loop. Because of the break keyword, whenever the break keyword is reached in the looping statement, program control will terminate that particular loop. Okay, so these are the forms we can write in while loop. Okay, we can consider the same things in do while loop and for. You can copy these things.
Okay.